हेलो
चेक करो।
यस सर।
यस यू नो वी कैन सी यू
सर वन सेकंड कम।
श्योर।
आई लव हिज अरे ऑफ यूटेंसिल्स माय गुडनेस।
यस
सर कार्विंग नाइव्स एंड इंप्लीमेंट्स आर सीरियस। रिमाइंड्स मी ऑफ अ सर्जरी।
एग्जैक्टली। All right, so here we go. We just start right away. Okay, good morning. Good morning, ma'am Annabelle. Good morning, Chef Feroz, and all you lovely people who are attending this webinar. My name is Melroy Gomes, and I welcome you all to our fourth webinar at DBCHS. The title for it is, It's Time to Carve Meat Kapish. You may be wondering, what is Meesh Kapish? Well, the word Meesh means beautiful carving display, and Kapish means to understand the feast place. Now, this title is given by none other than Andre, sir. Thank you, sir, for that. Since we have a webinar on carving, we have a guest, none other than Chef Feroz with us, who is the owner of Khan Fruit Carving. Thank you, Chef, for taking out the time to join us on this platform.
Thank you, sir.
I also would like to thank Areshodi, Ma'am Annabelle Rodriguez, for giving us such an opportunity. Ma'am, we couldn't do this without you. So thank you very much. Ma'am, would you like to share something?
Yes. Thank you, Melroy. Thank you but I know and I know that all this is possible because of all of you and the webinar team. You, Chef Melroy, Andre sir, Roma ma'am, Susan ma'am, and Prasad chef. So you guys have become a formidable team that has made this possible. I want to thank Feroz. Honestly, you have been a supporter, mentor, and co-collaborator of Don Bosco College Hospitality Studies. I think from the days we opened the doors, we are so grateful for all that you have taught the students and all the beautiful displays that you get them to do and you do for our Spectrum, which is our annual event that we have every December. We look forward to a continued and long collaboration. We are so happy that you have decided to do this webinar, because there are lots of kids sitting at home dying to do something creative, and this will be the spark that will get them started. Feroz, thank you very much, and now I'll leave it all up to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, ma'am. All right, Chef Feroz, I have some questions for you. Now, since we are teachers, you know, we tend to ask a lot of questions. But don't worry, this is not an exam. It's just a simple question, okay, related to you and your career. So my question to you, Chef, is could you tell us about your college? Like, which college did you pass from, or you did your from in which year? Yes, sir.
I did my hotel management from Rizvi College.
Okay.
It is in Bandra, Mumbai.
Okay.
And I proudly say I'm a Rizvi.
Okay. Lovely.
And I passed out in 2008-09.
Lovely. So, Chef, did you do any carving while you were in college, in your degree program, I mean?
Yes, sir. Because I learned this carving in my 8th standard when I was in my school.
Oh, wow.
So, after completion of the examination, we got vacation of 2 months, summer vacation.
Okay.
So I started working at Juh Chopati on a food stall. It's my uncle's stall. So they make pav bhaji, then they do Chinese food, they serve Indian food. So I started working there to help chefs over there to do meza.
Okay.
And this is the why I learned the carving from my chef over there. And the same technique I used to use in my college.
Okay.
For my seniors.
All right.
We used to do an event hospitality in Rizvi College.
Mm-hmm.
So for every batch, they used to do an event in hospitality.
Okay.
So I used to do carving for them, like every batch. And this is how I started doing in college.
Wow. So when did you, you know, start cow your first fruit or a vegetable, chef?
So I did it in the age of, I'll say, 12, 13 maybe, or maybe 14.
So you decided that you want to carve something and you, you know, directly picked up a paring knife and started carving? Or what was
No, sir. I was just copying my chef. He was making a small pineapple out of carrot.
Okay.
So I thought he, at least I'm not that good in doing carving. So right, at least right. I can copy my chef.
Right.
I'm a good copycat.
You're good at mirroring. Okay. Chef, also tell us who, as you said, you copied your chef. Okay, so who is that? Who inspired you for it?
So my chef name is Chef Sheru. He used to work on a cruise line.
Okay.
After his retirement, he started. He was in habit of working on tour sea because he was on cruise line.
Okay.
So the best place in Mumbai, the highest paid job was on a food stall in Mumbai. At Jew Chapati, because it was the highest paying job. That turnover for every day was good. So he used to get a good salary. And plus it was sea all around.
True.
So he is my mentor. He started doing first. Like,
so he's your inspiration.
Yes, sir.
For carving. All right. So now, chef, when you usually carve a fruit or a vegetable, so do you have any challenges to face? Now, for example, if you get a fruit or a vegetable which is ripe, which is overripe, or it's not up to your quality.
Yes.
So what are these?
So this mostly happens, see, when I teach in college, I give the best quality fruit for my students.
Okay.
And the same students, when it go to different colleges like YMCA, where our students go for the competition.
Right.
So when they come with the fruit, the person who get the fruit there. So he don't have any idea it is for the carving or for the eating. So that time it becomes very difficult for us to do carving. But still, it is a competition. We have to do it on any cost and we give our best in that. So we teach in such a way that students can do and give the 100% also on the right fruit and vegetables.
Okay. So you mean, chef, a carver should pick up his or her own fruits and vegetables?
Yes, sir. He personally should go to a market.
Okay.
You can see the shape and size of a fruit, what it is required.
Right.
Suppose you need a long pumpkin, you need a round watermelon. Okay. Depends on the size, on the variation, what he's doing.
Correct. Very true.
Yes.
So a person who is carving, you need to be a carver, you need to buy your own, handpick your own fruits and vegetables. Okay, cool. So chef, like today, you're showing us some demo. So what are these going to be like? I'll show
something basic where the students can learn out of this demonstration.
Okay.
See, if I'll do a like complicated design
or
integrated designs, it will be little difficult for the students to like catch it.
Okay.
And after like 15-20 minutes, half an hour, they'll start sleeping.
All right.
So I'll show them like few simple garnishes which they can do it today itself after seeing this demonstration.
Okay, chef. Okay. So now that's about it. I'm not going to ask you any more questions. I'm directly taking you to a PPT. You know, I've made a small PPT by gathering all pictures, what you have done in our college with our kids and so on. Okay.
So I can like speak in between of the PPT.
Yes. I'll give you a
chance. I can show the students like how much they can charge per piece and how the display looks, the size. So they'll feel better like when I'll do this carving.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Okay, just give a minute. I'll share my screen. Can I share my screen?
Yes, sir.
Pop up. Okay, so is it visible, ma'am?
Yes, absolutely.
Perfect. Beautiful. Perfect. So now I've got few pictures and images what I've collected, which is Chef Feroz's artwork. Now, since I told you he is the owner of Khan's Fruit Carving, so here it is. This is a small display, which Chef had done in our college at DVCHS. Chef, would you like to share anything? Chef Feroz?
So I'll share like on the main display, the bigger one.
Okay. So your chef has carved something on the watermelon, engraved the name of a college with some nice flowers, with beetroot, carrot, and so on. We'll go ahead. Here we have a pic with Chef Feroz with a beautiful Susan ma'am and the ever charming Annabelle ma'am. With this lovely display again.
Just a beautiful display.
Welcome, ma'am. Here it is.
Oh my God, Chef, that's work, beautiful.
A real work of art.
Wow.
It's a watermelon on the left hand side, and on the right hand side, it's a peacock, which is another watermelon. Chef, anything about this?
So these are the main designs which we sell in the wedding function, like many different functions, and we charge for this piece. The watermelon size over here is around 7 kg per piece.
Okay.
Usually charge like per piece is 600 to 700 rupees.
Wow. Per piece.
Yes, 1 hour requires to do this carving. This integrated carving.
It takes 1 hour to carve one watermelon.
Yes.
And per watermelon, it charges 700 bucks.
Yes, sir. 700 to 800.
Wow. That's a real piece of art, isn't it?
Yeah, just beautiful.
Beautiful. Absolutely. So precise. Very precise. Okay. Next, I would ask you, what is this, Chef? Because I just got the image and I'm trying to figure out what is this.
My student, he tried to make a papaya octopus.
Okay.
So this is
it's a papaya.
Yeah, it is a raw papaya. Peeled it and we tried to make an octopus out of it.
Wow. Looks nice. Looks very nice.
This was done by Chintamani.
Yes, Chef?
This was done by Chintamani.
Okay, this is done by Chintamani. No wonder. All right. Now, here it is. Is it a jack-o'-lantern? Now, you may be wondering what's a jack-o'-lantern. It's basically a pumpkin which is carved on a Halloween night. Am I right, ma'am?
Yes, absolutely. And this is just beyond a work of art.
Beyond. Oof. Because we usually are used to seeing that creepy face on a pumpkin. But this is something out of the world. Very nice, Chef. Okay, some displays of Chef. Here it's a huge display.
So this we have done in Leela Hotel.
Okay.
So you might be knowing Chef Kader, who was working in Leela for 25 years.
Right.
Yes.
So he was the person who gave me this contract.
Okay.
This was done for the wedding of the daughter of the owner of this property, Leela.
Oh, wow. Huge.
So he was like very happy after looking this display. And we had charged for this display was 45,000.
Okay.
Including all fruits and vegetables.
All right.
So this display, why I've shared this image? Because I want students to see this display.
Mm-hmm.
See, cutting only a carrot and a beetroot doesn't give you a good amount of income.
Very true.
See, we start from a beetroot and a carrot. But the intention is to make this type of displays.
Mm-hmm.
So for the students, if they learn the basic with me today, mm-hmm. so as I come to the college in future, they can come and enroll for this courses also. And they can learn all these integrated designs and how to set a display. It required time to learn. It required time to do this carving. Almost 12 hours we have taken to do all this. We were three of them to carve all display, plus 2 hours for the installation. But the reason to say all this is because see, when I start this class, it will be little lengthy, I'll say little boring, but you have to keep your interest 100%, you have to keep your josh 100% and learn this art. It is a very good thing. I've said in my demonstration also, students who learn carving, for them it is always job 100%, either it is in India or it is in foreign countries.
Very true.
Experience shared by my students who work in abroad.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. I'm done.
Thank you, Chef. I was about to ask you, how long did you take this? You rightly said it and mentioned it, that it took you 12 hours to do it.
Yes, sir.
And only three of them. Amazing.
Yes, sir.
Amazing.
Yes,
sir. All right, here is one more where I see a Barbie. Her dress is covered with watermelon. If you notice it.
Wow. Yes,
then there are some beetroot flowers. You can see some carrot, baby corn, pumpkin, swan. Lovely.
That's beautiful.
So this was done for a baby shower event.
Oh. Okay. Wow. Very nice. Very nice. All right. Here we have some of our alumni who have learned from Chef. We have Chagruti, we have Mario, we have Rohit.
You know, so,
yes,
Melroy, just to let everyone know, Jagruti is at graduated from George Brown. And she took a lot of this fruit carving and used it during her program. And today is working at with the Marriott Group and is also doing this, some forms of catering. Roshan is on the cruise lines doing very well for himself. And so is Mario. They've all taken their skills and put it to very good use.
All right. Thank you, ma'am. So these all were students, once upon students of Chef Feroz. Here we have Chintamani Urdu. You may be wondering who is Chintamani. Ma'am was talking about Chintamani. Here he is. He's the one.
Yes. So he's one of my best students.
True.
He has earned like a good amount by doing this carving display.
Yes, I certainly know that he was with you for a long period of time. Then he started his own, fruit carving business at home in a small scale and so on.
Yes.
So from day one, I could see this first pumpkin with his cow. This is so well done. Then these are learning in progress. These are our current students who are learning, I supposedly feel, in our college at Don Bosco. So here we have our BSc degree students as well as some short course students. And this is what they have done. Look at their work when they are learning. Amazing. Amazing. Obviously under the guidance of Chef Feroz, but isn't it, ma'am?
Yeah, Feroz, you have sparked an interest with all of them and they are continuously learning and upgrading their skills. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ma'am, this is possible because faculties are taking interest to teach students. There are a few colleges, they don't allow to do fruit carving. Mm-hmm. So I should thank first the management and the faculties there.
Absolutely. My food production team is absolutely stellar. And I know that Susan ma'am constantly makes sure that that you're there and you're connected with the college. And Melroy keeps making sure that they do some form of fruit carving with their displays, with his plating. And so does Chef Prasad and now Mehe ma'am and Sanna and Glenn. So thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. All right, for more details. Now, usually we need tools to carve. So here there are high quality handmade fruit and vegetable carving tools, which have been done by Chef Feroz. He probably has a factory of his own who delivers to you. If you want to order, you can contact him. His details are up here. He has a website, which is www.khanfruitcarving.com. Whereas he has a discount, you need to WhatsApp him. Okay, so you need discount, you have to WhatsApp. Otherwise, you won't get discount, okay? So, here are his details. And thank you for watching. Now we're going to go straight to Chef Feroz's kitchen. Let's see what he has for us.
So first I'll show all the knife and tools which I'm using.
Yes, absolutely. Excited though.
I'll be using few equipment to do carving today.
Sure.
The basic equipment is the peeler we have in our kit. These are the loop tools. These are the loop tools, very important tools to do fruit carving. It comes in a set this way.
Okay.
Wow. See, when we buy this on Amazon, it costs around 7,000 rupees. The same thing I gave in around 1,500 rupees max.
1500.
Wow.
Yes.
Good
deal. It's a steal. Yeah, fantastic.
And mom, this knife, like, it cost around 7,000 to 8,000 rupees. It is a two blade carving knife. The same knife I gave in 1850, 1850. It is almost 70% less the MRP. This is a two blade carving knife, which I'll be using today. So suppose one side it is blunt, you can use the second side.
Wow.
And it is whole metal body. It is a very good quality knife. Plus it is very secure. You have a metal cap. You can keep in your pocket, in your chef coat. I'll be using a paring knife today. This is a dragon carving knife. It is from China. Made in Korea. This cost around 7,000, ma'am, again on Amazon. And it is only available on Amazon.com. The same thing I'm giving in 1500 rupees. These are the 10-piece chisel set. Very important tools to do fruit carving. This is also available on Amazon. The same thing on my website. Amazon, it costs around 6,000 rupees. On my website, it is 1,600 rupees. Very important tool is the marking pencil. See, all pencils we can use, but this pencil is special because it works on the wet area. Suppose I want to do marking on a watermelon pulp. So this will work on pulp also. A normal pen or a pencil, it doesn't work on a pulp, on a wet surface. So this we can use on a wet surface. Suppose I want to do something. For example, a normal pencil will never work on this wet surface. This will easily work. Very good tool.
Wow. You
need to do marking. And plus, we can like remove it with a wet cloth. So nothing stays behind. Everything we can remove.
Wow.
There are a few more tools. This is a Comcom knife from Thailand. So these are the tools which I'll use today.
Okay.
I'll be using a toothpick, Satish tip. I'll be using a tape, green color tape today.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll be using a glue. It is a non-edible glue. This is only used for the non-edible displays.
Okay.
So with this help, we'll make lots of flowers today. I'll show the little advanced techniques today to all the students. So they'll get 100% out of this class today.
I'm sure they will, definitely.
And this is my brochure. It is all available on my website also. They can download PDF file of this. So they'll come to know what I'll be teaching today. This all garnishes I'll teach today. I'll try my level best to cover up everything today.
Okay.
Yes. So I can start now?
Yes, please.
Hope all students are enjoying.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
They all have been told to get a carrot and beat and a carving knife or a paring knife. So they have it already.
Ma'am, I'll show everything to you two times at least. So
okay.
That the students, once they will see, and next time they can do it with me also. The same
okay.
Time. So something okay. Very easy garnish, I'll start. Not mm-hmm. Too complicated, something very basic. We'll start from the letter A, then B, then C. So this is how I'll start today. First, I'll make a cone. A very simple garnish. Very important when you hold your knife. First thing, very important part, how to hold your carving knife. You have to always hold a knife, like students might be using paring knife today. It is fine for today, but if you need a good quality knife, you can get it from my website also. So this is the way With your middle finger, you have to hold it on a blade, half on a blade, half on the base, and with the thumb. And this is for the support, so that when I'll do carving, it won't slip out from my hand. These two fingers are very important. With this fingers, we can take a support and we can do carving. Now, there are two different angles. This is a straight angle, which I'll say 90 angle. The straight knife is a 90 angle. And slant will be 45 angle. Either it is in any way, any direction. For us, it will be 45 angle. And if it is straight, it will be 90 angle. See, now again, it is 90 angle. I turn the whole base. So it will remain 90 angle. And the slant one is the 45 angle. So when I say 90 angle, it will be straight knife. And when I will say 45 angle, it will be 45 slant knife. So with the slant knife, 45 angle. We have to carve it very delicate, very thin. Because the garnish which we serve on a plate, it is only for the eye appeal. You don't have to serve to make the guest stomach full only with the garnish. The purpose of the garnish is only to do a presentation and the eye appeal on a plate. A very simple garnish. Okay.
Lovely.
And after you make your carving, you keep it into the ice cold water. Okay, now one more thing. If suppose you want to serve this onto a plate. So whenever you serve any fruit or any vegetable, suppose it is a vegetable, you have to blanch it for 10 seconds, put in ice cold water, put this into the ice cold water, and then serve. Everything you serve on a plate, it has to be cooked. If you're serving it raw, it is non-edible and it is not allowed. So students, please keep this thing in mind. If any of your faculty sees your garnish, it is uncooked, you'll get straight away 0 marks for your presentation. I'll do it one more time. Again, I'll make a cone on the same side. A very thin pattern. You can throw this onto a plate.
Lovely.
So now I'll jump on to the next garnish. Students, please see this. It is something very simple. You can try it. You can make 4 petals, you can make 5 petals, depends on the size what you need. So the plate, 3 petals is more than enough. It is light in weight and it is good looking also. Okay, now the next garnish. I'll make a butterfly out of carrot. Ooh. The size you need a carrot. See, there are 3 blocks in a finger, right? So you have to take 2.5. Right? 1, 2.5 of this. Maximum size. You can take longer also. But this is more than enough. First cut, a very thin slice. Thin and flexible. The next cut,
Again, a thin slice.
So now we have two thin slices connected each other. Right? Now, the very first cut, I'll remove the unpeeled part first. First, I will make S, a very thin slice we have to remove. Yes, sir?
Yes, yes.
So, I hope all can see this.
Yes, we
absolutely can. Beautiful.
This is the first cut I did S. Now, again, on the same S, I will make a new cut using 90 angle. And I'll cut 3/4 of the slice. 3/4. And 1/4 I've left. So this will form an antenna of a butterfly.
Wow.
So this will form an antenna. Next cut from half of the carrot till the end to cut through the whole carrot. So this we can push it here. So this will come this way.
Wow.
The final cut. I will cut a V shape, but a curve V. And a reverse T. This is more than enough.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. The garnish is ready.
That is just beautiful.
Amazing.
Very good looking garnish. It requires a maximum 20 to 30 seconds to do this.
True. For you might be.
I know.
So when it comes in practice, students can easily do this. This is something very basic, very simple. What we can do is like, we can make the same butterfly here with a green color skin. So it looks this way. There is a butterfly cap here with a green color peel, and rest everything we can carve. So butterfly will stay there and rest everything will become a flower. So the same technique, I'll use it here on watermelon. Ma'am, I'll do this thing one more time.
Yes, just beautiful. Oh. Yes, yes.
Very thin slice. Two thin slices. Connecting in center. Right? It has to be very flexible.
Mm-hmm.
So now the first cut, I will remove the unpeeled part and I'll make a S in the same time. This is the first cut I have removed. Second cut. So here is the antenna ready. The third cut from the half of the butterfly till the end. Then the fourth cut, I'll make a curve V. And the last cut is a reverse C.
Whoa.
Okay,
butterfly is there.
Beautiful.
This we can blanch and we can serve it onto a plate. So it will be partially cooked, plus it will be edible and very good for the state presentation.
Wow.
This is a very good eye appeal. Very light in weight, not more than 5 grams. Chef, hope you all are liking this video.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's just beautiful. I expect to see lots of those butterfly students. A lot of them when the lockdown opens. Like butterflies, we are all going to emerge and come back to college. So I need to see a lot of them.
Now the leftover carrot. We can make many, many garnishes out of this also. I will show few garnish. Something very simple. Then 3 slices out of this. First cut. Second cut. The third cut. First. Second. And the third cut. So the, I have done a N shape cut. Shape of a N. Right?
Right.
And then this we have to twist this one.
Wow.
Oh.
That is simple. Cool.
The students can do the same garnish on capsicum, triangular capsicum. Mm. So green, yellow, red. So they'll get 3 colors on a plate. The reason to add garnish is, one of the reason is to add color, like more color to a plate.
Mm-hmm.
To make your plate more attractive. And make one more. So here are the 3 cut garnish. So here is your end ready. So this is how. Here, so usually students make a mistake in folding. See, this is the first part and this is the last part.
Mm.
If I hold it ulta on the opposite side, and when I turn, so it won't set properly. So I have to turn in the same way. This
one. Lovely, like little mini Eiffel towers.
Yes,
it's just beautiful.
Very nice and very quick.
I know.
I'll move on to the next gun and keeping all this thing in water. Now I made a M. This was an N cut. So now I'll make M. Shape of a M. First cut, second, third, and the last cut. So here is the end.
Oh.
This was the end.
Right.
Only one extra cut. It is all same. It is similar.
Hmm.
Only one extra cut here. So it forms M. Now. With this, I'll make a star shape. I'll turn this first part, I'll put it behind. Understood?
Yeah.
Or you can do it this way. From behind, you can bring it in front. And here, this, you have to put it behind. The same way.
Oh,
oh man.
It will form a star shape.
Fantastic.
Yeah. Sir, ये बहुत ज़्यादा easy तो नहीं हो रहा है.
No, no, it's
no, no.
We need that basic first.
Yeah.
Or else my students will sleep.
No, no, no.
No, no, this is the building blocks.
Thank you. Okay, I'm doing it one more time. See, this is the first part. Second cut, the cut has to be similar. The thickness of each cut has to be similar. Suppose I'm cutting 5 mm here, the second cut will also be 5 mm. At least approx 5 mm. Third cut and the last cut. So here is the M. First is here.
Perfect.
Lovely.
So simple, but so much of show it gives.
It looks very attractive on plate, ma'am.
Yes, very, very.
This same thing we can do with we can serve with carrot, one with turnip, one with beetroot. So again, it will give three colors.
Three colors.
Wow.
So students understood the fold, how to do this? Or I'll show it one more time, the fold.
We should be. We'll move ahead.
Hello. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Good morning. Yeah. I'm so sorry, I'm in a webinar. Can I call you back?
Okay, now the last, the similar cut, the final. Again, I'm doing the same M cut. But this time I'll hold it opposite direction, W. So what I have to do is, I'll turn both the handles inside the V, the center part. And it's done.
Oh.
This was done with the M. This is done with the W. And this is done with the N shape. So, N, M, W. Okay, I'll move forward. Okay, now I'll show the same end cut using cucumber. I'm not peeling cucumber. Okay, now I'll insert my knife in the center. I'm not cutting from the tip. I'm putting it in the center. Right? Only in the center I'm cutting. Okay, now there is a line here. See, here there is a line. Right? So there is a start and there is an end here. Same on the other side. There is a line here. Here there is a start, here there is an end. So what I'll do is I'll start from the starting point, I will connect to the ending point of the next cut. So again it will form N shape.
Yes.
And then the other part again from the start to the end of the next cut.
Oh,
something very simple, very delicate. We can do same thing with carrot. We can do same thing with radish. It is a type of fruit cut also. You can take a block of a watermelon, cut the same direction and arrange it in a line on a platter. So it will become your fruit platter with a vertical cut. This looks
wow. Beautiful.
Suppose chefs have used the upper part, only the white card and he has left the seat. He has left the seat. He don't require his seat. So the students who go on their training, so they can use this chance. They can just pick up the seat. Just make a cut in center, doing the same design. See, from here till here, I'll make a cut. Proper center cut. Then again, I'll connect the start point and the end point of the second side. It is the same cut.
Oh.
It is the same end cut. So your students are learning.
Lovely. Yes.
So this is the same cut. We can do like one on cucumber, one on carrot. My knives are very sharp.
I can see that.
You can shave with this knife. It is razor sharp. So seriously, I always keep my knife razor sharp. So this is how we can arrange
on a platter.
This is your platter cut. Suppose I'm serving muskmelon, then I'm serving watermelon, then I'm serving papaya. So this is how we can arrange. Right? Properly we can arrange it.
All right.
Beautiful.
Yeah. So I'll move on to the next one. I'll use this leftover carrot. Now I'll show something with the chisel. If the students are not having this chisel, how they can use it then? You can take a can, a normal Pepsi can or a Coke can, and if a lid nikalke, you can just turn it. And it will form this shape. When I started learning, I was not having this tool. For me, it was like very difficult to get tools that time because it was very expensive. Even today also it is expensive, but I'm trying to make it, I'm trying to sell this in a very less price so that all students can afford to buy and they can do this fruit carving. Yeah, I made a circle in center. I'm cutting in 45 angles, slant cut. then I'll make it smooth. I've inserted this cheese in 45 angle inside, slant. Use the loop tool. Cut in center just to highlight this flower. Now, my flower is ready. I'll cut from the base. And here it comes.
Whoa.
Beautiful.
Okay. Something very simple.
Oh my goodness. That is just beautiful.
And we can make a small flower arrangement with this. And we can keep it onto a platter. I will share a few more images of garnish, how to set it. So, sir can pass it to the students.
Sure.
I'm just showing there is a way, like a proper way to serve all this garnish. So, now it is only a demonstration class, so I'm trying my best to serve as many garnish as I can. I'll do this garnish one more time. Ma'am, this art requires lots of patience. Students have to like sit for like hours and to do practice to learn this. I spend my days like turning into nights. Made a circle with 90 angle with a cheese in. I did this circle with 90 angle using a cheese in. And then using a carving knife, I removed the side part with a slant cut 45 angle. Right? Now, I will insert the same U cheese in it comes in a combination of U and V. There are many chisels. The name for this is also a UV chisel, we say. This is all imported from Thailand, this chisel. Again, I'm inserting 45 angle. If students want, they can do marking also. They can do marking and then they can do. Students mean they can do marking on tip of a petal also. This is an extra cut.
Lovely.
We did one extra cut here on top. So this way we can arrange like small flowers, big flowers. We can arrange the whole bouquet and we can serve it on a platter. A small, small bouquet. So you can keep it onto a platter in one corner. Only like students go to waiting, they use platter to serve their starters. So we can just keep it on a corner and we can serve a starter here. So it will give a feel to the platter also. So I'll just move on to the next garnish. This is done. Okay, now I'll make one more flower only with the chisel, only with the chisel. Here I use a big size chisel. Now I'll use a small chisel. A small size chisel. There are different shapes in this set, different sizes are there.
So, sir, there's a V-shaped, U-shaped, and a small one. Three chisels.
Yes, yes. And there are total 10 pieces.
Oh, okay.
There are 10 piece chisels.
Oh, okay.
There is a loop chisel. There are many chisels. There we get loop also.
Oh.
I wow. I just remove whatever I need today.
Okay. Okay, okay.
Make a phone here. Thank you. Now I'll make the whole slab using small cheese. U-shaped cheese. Students can use, like, if they have cheese set, they can make the same flour with V-set also. V-shaped cheese.
Okay.
It will look like a marigold flour. Now I'll be using this blade, flexible blade, because I'll be doing lots of curves. So we need flexible blade here. First, I did 45 angle using this chisel.
Right.
The second cut was 90 angle using a flexible blade. Now, again, I will do 45 angle in center of two petal. This one. Now I'm doing my third layer. And now the last layer. Again, I'm doing 45 angle. But this time I'm going little deep inside. So it will form a V shape in center. And the leftover will come out. Here are the four layers on a flower. This flower is ready.
Beautiful.
Now it's like students want to like occupy like a huge space, so they can stick petals here. They can
cut
petal shape out of carrot and they can stick it here. So this flower will become quite huge this way, a big size. Wait, I'll just show. Just cut one slice. Now this flour will become non-edible. This will go only on platter. This glue is not easily available on any hardware shop. This we get only in industrial area. My dad is an engineer, so he usually gets this glue for his machining work. See, it is very fast. No? Just make few leaves out of this.
Find the name for the webinar on business.
Is that your
yes, ma'am.
Your
yes,
son?
Yes,
so how many kids?
Ma'am, I have two kids.
Hello. Hello, I remember you. Hi. Are they learning also right away?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I can imagine. Look at them. They're so involved.
And my wife also, she learned.
Oh, fantastic. Become a family affair.
Yes, ma'am. I'll just do slicing.
Oh, wow.
And this will form a book plan, book size plan.
That is just amazing.
And because of you and your college students are learning all these ideas.
Wonderful.
And I spent so much of money to learn all this.
I know.
Our students will thank your management, your faculties for this.
Yes. And I really do hope that all of them take to this as with the same passion that you have and the same dedication, because this doesn't happen because you watch one session. You have to keep at it. You have to keep taking more classes. You have to keep practicing and keep creating.
Mom, these are students, they want everything ready-made. But if they'll,
absolutely.
They can do this, ma'am, if they give some time.
Yeah.
But all are busy in their phone on Facebook.
Right. Only today we want them to be on Facebook so that they can see you live.
Yes, ma'am.
But while they are seeing you live, they need to be practicing. Yeah.
Now, whatever I'm showing today, it is very simple. They can easily.
Yeah. Where do you get this glue? Do you also sell the glue with the...
Yes, ma'am. It is there on my website also.
Okay, good.
Ma'am, this is a bond which we used to stick to steel. Like if I put in between of this, it will stick.
And it won't break in.
It is that strong.
Okay. So that's why it sticks even when the things are wet and
Yes.
Okay. That is just spectacular.
Very nice.
Absolutely spectacular.
This can be easily kept on the, because it has a very huge base, big size base, so it can stand onto a platter. Suppose I'm serving my chicken tikka or any wasabi prawns, my starter on my platter.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
So this can be served onto a plate on a platter.
So just beautiful.
A platter gun. And students want, they can cut here in center also. So when they'll keep in water, so this leaf will curl, it will turn, it will become crisp. Keeping everything here. Yes. And move on to the next garnish, cucumber.
Yes.
Sachin, what time I have to take? Sir? No, right, sir?
Yes, sir.
Sachin, what time I have to take this demonstration?
Sir, you can take as much long as you can.
Because I'll be carving pumpkin, I'm planning to carve papaya, then watermelon, then muskmelon, everything.
Everything will take around 2 to 3 hours.
Ma'am, sir, I can do till evening.
So my thing to you is, chef, we probably have till about 12:15. If you'd like to show them those three, but you can do it at your pace, because if they want to learn, then they will come for your class.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
Okay.
And I'll just show this cucumber and then I'll move on to the papaya.
Lovely.
I've divided this cucumber with 90 angle into 6 equal parts.
Right.
First I've divided them into 2, then I've put in 2 more cuts. So it is now 6 parts. Then I'll cut the corners of the cucumber. I will cut the same shape in the center. I'll cut between the skin and the pulp. Wow. You can turn this.
Oh!
Wow. That's gonna bloom when you put it in ice cold water, isn't it?
Yes, sir. I was not able to get the green color cucumber because nowadays like vegetable is difficult to get here in Vikhroli. It is a like all cases are coming here, so all the market are closed. So whatever I got, I bring. What did you have to do the demonstration? For this we need that green color Chinese cucumber.
Right.
So it looks very nice, green on the skin, white inside.
Right. We have the color contrast.
Yes, sir.
Perfect.
When I put this into the water, it will turn a little crisp. And here in the center, we can like put some carrot.
Therefore, how long do you can store these? Like, can I take one day prior or something?
So this flower, I can store it for 30 days.
30 days?
Wow. Yes,
you mean after usage as well?
Yes, sir. So what I do is like I make one display, mostly in the wedding season in winter.
Okay.
I make one display and I keep it ready in the fridge. Whenever I get wedding order. Hey, Sana, isko pakdo, dekho, gira degi, sir. Whenever I get wedding order, I put there this display. And I say then, sir, I'll wind up everything, I'll clean everything and I'll go. So I wrap everything and I bring it home.
Okay.
Next day, the same display I put in some other wedding.
Okay. So it can 5,000. Be
used. Yes. Okay. I just put 5,000 rupees to make one display and I sell in 20,000 in 5-6 weddings.
Fantastic.
Ma'am, this is how I survive, ma'am.
Yes. You're not surviving, you're thriving. You're thriving.
Yes, ma'am.
So is it important when you make a display, is it important to just water it or spray it every time?
No, so just put in ice cold water for some time, like 5-10 minutes, and then keep in airtight container.
Okay, no, I'm talking about when you put a display. When you put up a display.
Yes. So you have to spray water there.
Yeah.
Yes.
So what is the time, intervals that you need to spray
like
water?
Like in 1 hour, once in 1 hour.
After every 1 hour, okay.
Yes.
So is it important to have OSS now?
Yes, we set everything on OSS.
Okay.
Because the phones, when we put on a display, we usually put inside the OSS.
Okay.
And then on top of the OSS, we keep our centerpieces.
All right.
Ma'am, it is done.
Lovely.
So for those who don't know what OASIS is, it's a foam that is used, a floral foam that is used to set your flowers on when you're doing flower arrangement and you're carving when you're setting up a carving arrangement. It's green in color and you get it in huge boxes anywhere where there's a wholesale flower market.
Then we can use the starting stick as a stem and we can insert into the OSS.
Oh, lovely.
So it's coming into a green color. I've used this tape, green color tape. Now I'll do one papaya carving now.
Yes. The last papaya carving.
I'm going to worry you for one watermelon carving.
Yes, ma'am. So, ma'am, do I do watermelon first?
Yes, please.
Okay.
It's your signature and it's so beautiful.
Thank you. And you can first draw a circle using a compass. I'm making a flower inside this watermelon first. I'll make a flower and then I'll make petals here.
Lovely.
It's a revision for my students who are doing carving in your college, man. Because I've completed this class with them.
Oh, lovely.
And ma'am, I teach 100%. You can ask any of my students. They will do it on any course, ma'am. Become easy with this thigh carving knife, this flexibility.
Right.
So easy.
I know. The hands are moving so fast.
Exactly.
Wow.
The twist, the turns. You want extra chip comes out. Wait. There's a lot of practice.
Yes, sir, we need only practice. True. Give me 5 days, I'll make you do food carving.
No, for sure. We're going to have a workshop for our team. Once the lockdown is done.
Yes.
Whoa, that is just beautiful.
So, chef, can we even store this watermelon?
So, we can use this watermelon for 7 weddings.
For 7 days?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
And we have to keep it in a normal refrigerator.
Mm-hmm.
I have a commercial refrigerator at my home.
Okay.
So, I store it at my home.
All right. So, you snap it with film or something and then you can keep it. Is that?
Sir?
Do you need to wrap it in a cling film or plastic
wrap? Sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Clean that we wrap it.
Okay.
So for the students, it is one of the best idea for their part-time job also.
Yeah.
They can learn and they can do in catering also. In Mumbai, say easily 20,000 they get for one display.
Wow.
Wow.
And the expense is only 5,000 rupees. Just they have to do hard work. They have to get fruits, they have to get vegetables, they have to carve it, they have to store it, they have to transport everything, they have to take care. This is one of the easiest design. With the same petal, we can make around 34, 35 more patterns.
Mm-hmm. This is easier maybe for you, chef.
Okay, it is easy. So just see this petal, this one.
Uh-huh.
Just doing zigzag. So it will form a next petal.
Mm-hmm.
second pattern, second design. With the same pattern, there are so many patterns.
So that probably gives a 3D effect.
Yes, yes, yes. So see what I did. You can see?
Yes, yes.
There are so many different designs and patterns. If students want to do, they can easily do this. I practice, sir, every day.
You practice every day, still
every, now? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Every day in morning I do my practice.
No wonder you're a master.
The problem, sir, with the students is they don't do practice.
Yeah, that's what. When you stop, you stop practicing, your habit goes away and then you tend to, not do anything.
All this is muscle memory, right?
Yes.
So if you're not going to practice, your hands and your muscles are not going to know in what direction to move. So you have to keep at it every day.
Right. But usually what I feel is, students are a bit scared, if they screw up something, what are they going to do? But they don't understand one thing. From that, you're going to learn something new.
Absolutely.
Even we do recipes. I do. I also screw up. I also tend to burn things. From that you get to learn.
Absolutely.
I try to tell everybody. Don't be afraid. Just go.
You learn to rectify.
Yes.
And you might actually come up with something else.
Very true.
Yes.
You'd know the easier way to do it, in fact.
Absolutely.
Or some different, another method of doing it.
Absolutely. And I'm thinking, what's the worst thing if you actually ruin a fruit carving? You're getting to eat it then.
Exactly. But if you don't eat it, just juice it up.
Right, exactly. So
you have these bits and pieces.
Yes. So many things to be done with the watermelon.
Right, right.
Ma'am, it's a very healthy art.
Yep. You're getting to brine the skin, all that white rind you can make
a
vegetable and chutney out of, the fruit, you're going to get juice and sorbet. And plus, if you're successful, you've got a beautiful display.
Yeah, very much.
Yeah, fear is something that you need to get over, I think, if you want to, especially because you're working also with such sharp tools. So the fear of getting cut and the fear of all of that also adds to their apprehension.
Now when students start doing practice, they become very normal now.
Right. And also if you get comfortable with one design, you must move on to the next and try a new one. I have to confess that when I was in college, I had learned how to make a swan. And I got so complacent that I started doing it for everything. And I remember someone coming up to me and saying, "Have you seen another bird? Do you want to try something else?" So, make sure that you keep adding to your repertoire and adding to your portfolio so you have a whole lot of designs. And the more you know, obviously, the more you're going to be able to do and the more you're going to be able to earn.
Yes,
ma'am. I mean,
and for a new design, you don't have to search anywhere. Just do one mistake in your carving.
Right.
And continue making that same mistake again and again. And you'll get a very new centerpiece.
That is just spectacular what you have done. In minutes. In minutes.
In minutes.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. once it is done.
Oh, that is absolutely beautiful. Absolutely spectacular. My goodness.
And then this one piece, it will give me 800 to 900 rupees, maybe 700 rupees.
Fantastic. Wow. And this was like in minutes. Beautiful. Obviously with all the hard work and the diligence and the practice.
Yes.
Oh. To all my students who are watching, the new ones who are going to join us and the ones who have joined and all the guests, I hope you understand that most people have two or three streams of income, and this is a great stream to add on to your mainstream. It is something that you can keep doing and learning, and the repertoire is so much for weddings, for parties, you know, for proposals. You could do this and put "Will you marry me" on it. You can put it to say, "Oh, congratulations, you've graduated." So many things. This is like a licensing deal that you can do and make sure that you use it for all kinds of events.
Yes.
Absolutely beautiful.
Ma'am, you want me to show one more thing?
I would love it. I would love it. On the pumpkin, the papaya, whichever one you're... Ooh, lovely. Pumpkin. Yes, no, lovely.
You're saying swan, so I'll make a swan on this. Very quick.
Oh, beautiful. Yes.
One second, my battery is gone. So I just put one.
Okay. All right. To all the students and all the guests who are watching, you know, this, a lot of people spend a lot of money on beautiful flower arrangements. Of course, we need the flowers. But when you are putting up food, it is always an added accent to have a beautiful fruit carving and a beautiful display of fruit and of vegetables, because it makes the entire display very, very fresh. For all the bartending students who love to make beautiful cocktails, you're going to be able to get a whole heap of new garnishes that you can use on your glass, at the side of your glass, maybe on your bar counter, to represent the drink that you're making, or maybe even form a holder for your drink. Mm-hmm. So I hope all of you are watching this. The ideas are endless. Now it's up to y'all to be able to make sure that you practice and use this everywhere. You know, that's another thing. I've been watching you, Chef. I love that you have such a clean workspace. For most of you students who keep saying, "No, I'll clean up at the end of my doing what I'm supposed to be doing." This is an extremely good habit to have, where your workspace is absolutely clean. A clean workspace is a clean mind, is a fabulous final product.
Chef has actually set an example. You know, we always say clean as you go.
Right.
That's what Chef is doing.
Chef has been doing from the beginning. Yes. Fantastic.
And so this is what we learn in the start of a college.
Exactly.
In the first year. That's our faculty is their first day thing. Say this. We use, keep doing cleaning first.
Right.
I should thank my faculties for this. Mm-hmm. Especially thanks Chef Ram Kumar, Chef Kumar sir, Chef Santosh. If they're watching me live now. Chef Kumar is the principal of Rizvi College.
Okay.
Okay, now I'll just make a So, and a U shape, V, reverse S, reverse U, a leaf shape, reverse V, and a reverse T. My swan is ready.
Man, that was in seconds.
That is, yeah. It's okay. I think most students, if you start sketching on plain paper to start off with, it will get your hand in the right, kind of position to be able to draw. And the more you sketch, the better it'll be. So then when you finally come onto the pumpkin, it will make it a little easier for you.
Ma'am, just what we need is alphabet, A, B, C, D. That's it. If we know how to write an alphabet, we can easily do this.
Fantastic.
I won't take more than 4 minutes for this pumpkin slide.
Chef, I want to say we are getting a lot of messages, and so I wanted to read it to you. We have Anuja Dalvi, ma'am, who said, wonderful carving by Chef. Superb. So beautiful.
Thank you.
Our student, Bignesh, who is who has graduated and who is on the cruise line, said, good afternoon, ma'am. Thank you for this wonderful class. Our student, Meryl Pereira, who is extremely good at food production, says, amazing chef. So there are a whole heap of chats that are coming, and thank you. Wow.
Thank you.
You're like a wizard, Chef. Whoa. It's amazing to watch it come alive as you're just masterfully Tipping away.
Ma'am, now the last cut. We make feathers of a swan.
Whoa!
Here on top, I'll use small pieces. चलो मना करो बच्चे शोर मचा रहे हैं.
Oh my goodness.
Amazing.
I'll just put one eye here.
That's an eye for
this. That is just beautiful. My God. What is that? A button or what is it?
Ma'am, this is specially for this only. It is the shape of a... This is... It comes only for the carving.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow.
Ma'am, these are not available in the market. You can easily get it from
okay.
the...
Okay. Okay, okay, okay. Beautiful. Wow. Absolutely beautiful.
Now it comes in a packet of 10,000 pieces.
Wow!
I'll just remove this, ma'am.
Yes. I'm sure also over the years you have managed to form really good connections with your fruit dealers, right?
Yes,
to get
ma'am.
The best fruit.
Yes,
that
ma'am.
Is an important... Wow! Oh my goodness. Just beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Ma'am, I'll put everything, whatever I have made here.
Yes, beautiful. Students, I can imagine you have, and all our guests, I can imagine now you have a lot of things to try, a lot of things to work on. It's going to keep you busy. You have another whole month of lockdown, so I'm expecting a lot of you to make sure that you And all these are easily available. Carrots, cucumber, the watermelons are still available. Pumpkins are still available. So it should be, really easy for you to keep practicing. And remember, if you're not going to be using it, you got to eat it. So you're going to be able to get a whole lot of other recipes also along with your carving. Absolutely spectacular.
Yes, ma'am.
We also have Chef Prasad who has sent a message to say superb session. Yes. Thank you so much, Chef Melroy.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Chef Lewis, for showing us, so many carving from the basic to the intermediate, like a pro.
Yes.
Thank you very much once again to take out the time for us and our students. And that's about it.
And so I just want to say one thing.
Yes.
Especially for the students. Guys, see, if you want to do fruit carving, first thing you need is the carving tools. Just don't go on Amazon.com or .in and buy there. The same product, they take it from me and then they sell on Amazon on the higher rate. So if you are buying any product, you just type on Google fruit carving in India. On a very first search, you'll get my website, farmfruitcarving.com. And I've listed all my products there on a very nominal rate. I just kept 50-100 rupees profit for me, that's it. And I'll do free delivery at your home. It is all like free delivery anywhere in India. So don't go and buy the expensive knife and tool. They will take it from me only and they will give it to you on the higher rate. So here, due to the college, I should thank college also. They have given you all the chance to come to the main source to get fruit carving tools and knife and the fruit carving classes also. Yes.
Lovely. So Chef, just a thing I want to thank Firoz. Mr. Firoz Khan for taking the time to do this, but most importantly to all my students and all the guests who are watching, to know that Chef continuously has classes, and I have seen the benefits of actually going to his class and working alongside him, because he gives complete attention to every single student. All our students that have done your course have benefited from it. The hustlers are the ones who will actually make use of it. But I think this is an art, whether you use it or not, adds to your life. And for the ones who use it, it's absolutely fantastic. I would suggest to everybody, definitely go on to to Chef's website. Definitely go on WhatsApp and get your tools, because it will enhance your experience and it will make it a whole lot easier for you to go just from the basic to all the advanced stuff that you have seen on Sir's portfolio. So with that, Firoz, we are extremely grateful to have this collaboration with the Khan Academy and Don Bosco College Hospitality Studies. Everybody go on to the website, go on to the WhatsApp and get your discount. We all love our discounts, and I think it's a great value for money. And honestly, I cannot wait to see a whole lot more of these done by the students. Just to let you know that as soon as the lockdown is done, my entire team will be doing a whole bunch of sessions with you. So
thank you
very, very much.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Melroy Chef, and my entire webinar team. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.